This is your boy DR Period, Mr. AKA Inspirational Rock Boy, and welcome to another edition of DR Period Beats. DR Period, period, period. Okay, let's talk on this episode about DR Period, the artist. Let's take it back a little bit. Let me tell you a story. This is all going down in the early 90s. Where I first started discovering the artist side of DR Period, I should say. I got a deal with a company called Hurricane Records. And the name that I was going by was Dr. Daryl D and DJ Omega Supreme. And Omega Supreme was my DJ. R.I.P. to DJ Omega Supreme. He passed away. Very good brother. Very solid, very talented. He lost a very, very, very good soldier. So his passing took me off the path of being an artist because I didn't know how to continue on going. I tried and tried, but it just didn't feel right, you know? I had two dancers. I had Egypt and I had Aztec. And we used to practice a lot. We used to do a lot of good things. I mean, we was a real awesome team. You know, all four of us. I mean, we really had some things going. But everything changed. And then I transitioned to DR Period, the producer. So, for years, I always had the artistry in me. And when I became DR Period, the producer, on a full-time basis where that's what I did all day, every day, I always included DR Period, the artist. See, the artist side of me, it was about writing and producing and making records. That's what I'm very strong at. And I did a lot of that behind the scenes. I did a lot of TV shows. I did a lot of movie placements. I did a lot of commercials, a lot of jingles. I wrote records for other artists. I developed a lot of acts. I put a lot of people in good positions and been involved in a career from the very, very, very beginning. The story goes like this. A whole nother lit. How this record came about was, it came out of nowhere. You know, right now, I'm in a space where God is communicating with me heavy. And God let me see the records that I need to focus on and the beats that I need to make for this specific project that I'm doing. And I'm in here scoring a movie, an independent movie, and this record that I put into the movie, it had this one section. It's an old school record. And I heard that one little bit is like no more than four bars. It goes like this. That's all I heard. When I heard that, all I could think about is the way that little instrument rhythm in that one little section made me feel. I was like, it feels good. That little part right there by itself, the way they singing, the way the melody is, all of it connected. It was a moment. I said, that's gonna be hard. I said to myself, that's gonna be hard. And not hard in the way to do, but hard in the way if I do it right. People hear it, that's gonna be one of those tracks that they're gonna be like, yo, that beat is mean. So I decided to say, let me flip it. Let me play with it. Let me touch it. Let me do what I do best. So I'm in here working on the joint. And by the time I finish the joint, some say, you know what? That little section motivated you to create this beat. Keep that section as the opening to the beat. And then just let the beat rock from there. And that's what I did. And that's how I came up with a whole nother lick. DR period, period.
Got a whole new drip. Can't stop, won't stop, can't quit. Cause the Lord promised me victory right now. And I'ma tell you that's a whole nother lick. That's a whole nother lick.
That's a whole nother lick.
That's a whole nother lick. Cause the Lord promised me victory right now. And that's a whole nother lick. Everybody say, got a whole new drip.
Got a whole new drip.
And I cannot quit.
And I cannot quit.
Cause the Lord promised you victory right now. And that's a whole nother lick.
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 To the root, a lot of y'all wouldn't be who you are if the Lord wouldn't have never stood by you. See, a lot of things in life change.